Okay, good afternoon, friends. Let's start today. In last lecture, people just attempted a test on verbal ability. So very few students have attempted, only 20 students have attempted the test. So test might be a little bit difficult, but you people have to prepare for such tests, and for that, I hope that you people might be using the websites related to aptitude, that India Bakes or Career Ride. So there you will find such questions for practice. So there will be tests like this. So you people just prepare for verbal ability tests also. So there, if you are just going for aptitude, you people can search there for verbal ability questions also. Okay, so because of that, you people will know answers also, and some difficulty level will be high there. So in that way, you people just keep yourself up to date. So I hope that you people might have received scores also. So accordingly, you just judge yourself, check where you are exactly and where you are expected to be. So if you think that the whatever score you got, if it is satisfactory, then I don't think that anybody will feel that your scores are satisfactory. So in fact, if it is not satisfactory, in that case, you people have to think that where you should be or how much you should get. So accordingly, you just prepare, plan and practice. So because as we people have to work on various aspects, like oral communication, as well as we people have to prepare for verbal ability, written communication as well. So for that, you people have to consider all those things and take some time for practicing these things. Okay, so we will go back to our practice of the situational phrases, words, sentences that we people were learning. So let's start. So you people just tell me that last time I think we have completed these phrases for talking or asking about jobs that we have done last time. So today we'll start from this only. So here, we people have discussed that how we people can ask someone, where do you work? We may ask, what do you do? I told you that difference between what do you do and how do you do. Or you may ask that, what do you do for a living? Or you can tell that where exactly you work. You can say, I work at Microsoft, Google, I work at Infosys, I work at number of the companies that you people are having opportunities to work, and accordingly you just use it. Or you people can tell what occupation you people are following. You can say, I'm a teacher, I'm a doctor, I'm an accountant, I'm a CA or mechanical, or all those occupations that we people have discussed. Or if you don't have any job, in that case, you can say, I am unemployed. Or you people can also mention that I am between jobs at the moment. So when you say I'm between the jobs, it means that you have left your earlier job and you're searching a new job. Then I'm looking for work. I'm a stay-at-home mom, dad. Or I run my own business. I'm a freelance, and I told that what a freelance means. And I am retired. All those phrases that we people can use to talk about a job. So from these words, these phrases, you just try to modify these questions, these sentences in your own words. There is no need to that people have to learn them by heart and then try to speak. It is not like that. Simply, you people just think that what you can ask, what you can answer based on the information that you have. It is not necessary that these words, these phrases, these sentences only you have to follow. Not necessary. You can make your own sentences also. So therefore, now let's start from this, that phrases for describing relationships. So here also, I would like to tell you that in our Indian culture, we people have a number of relationships. So we have relationships from our mother, we call it maternal relationships, and relationships from our father, that is we call paternal relationships. So considering that we people have cousins and aunts and aunties and many people that we are associated with. But in Western culture, when they refer to relationships, there they have such a narrow meaning of relationships that they just think of their own. I mean, it's only spouse and their siblings and offsprings. So that much is. So they don't consider more people, or if they have such kinds of cousins or like these people, they don't consider them relationships. From that point of view, we are going to see few phrases which are used to talk your relationship. So before that, you just let me know that is voice audible clearly to you and screen is also visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, good. Then let's start. So I just told you that these are relationships to limited to you, or it is your relationship. So in that case, you can say I'm single. When you're going to say you're single, it means that you're not engaged or you're not married or you don't have any relationships, personal relationships. In that case, you can say that I am single. Then the next phrase, you will find that I just told you that these kinds of things which are not expected in our culture, because this information or the slides that are prepared, that are from Western culture, so mostly in American, so they can openly and normally they talk about boyfriend and girlfriend. But in our culture, if somebody is talking about I have a boyfriend or I have a girlfriend, then people will just start making fun of these people, and it is not expected, allowed in our culture. So people just neglect this because you cannot use it. Next, you people should go to the next point, and it means you can use it related to if your engagement is fixed or if it is engaged. So in that case, you can say we are engaged, and engaged means we are going to get married. So maybe sooner or later, maybe within next month or soon, you people are going to marry. In that case, you people can use this, that we are engaged. Then next, point number four, that we are getting married in June. So if it is fixed and if it is planned in the next month or in coming month, then you people can just say that we are getting married in June, or you can use it accordingly. Or if you're already married, in that case you can say I am married. And if you're married and for long time, if you're married, so you can just say that I have been married for 10 years. So you can just change this 10 years. I have been married for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 7 years, 10 years, 20 years. So as per that situation, it can be modified. Then next, the relation situation might be that I am divorced. So if somebody is saying divorced, it means that they're living separately. So maybe if a male is there, that he is living away from his wife, and if a female is there, she's living away from her husband. So in that case, they are divorced. So next, if somebody is saying I'm widowed, so in that case, you people have to understand that if a male says that I'm widowed, it means that his wife has died, and if a female says I'm widowed, in case her husband has died, in that case it can be used that I am widowed. Then next is that I'm not looking for anything serious. In that case, you are not thinking of having any relationships. That means that you're not thinking of having a marriage or any other such kinds of relationships. You wanted to stay single. So in that case, you can say, I'm not looking for anything serious. And last one is that I'm not quite over my ex. So after ex, you people have to use that ex-husband, ex-wife, or ex-boyfriend, ex-girlfriend. And when you are saying that I'm not quite over my ex-husband, ex-wife, it means that I still have feelings for my ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend. So you may be having breakup, you may be having divorced, but still, if you're having feelings for that person, in that case, you people have to use this expression. Okay, so these were the phrases, sentences. Again, you just try to search more on the internet, and important is that you people start using them various situations, because we come across with number of people throughout the day. We people chat with them, we people talk with them, and these are normal situations that we people have to discuss there also. But in our mother tongue, we don't find any problem to talk with these people. But as far as English is concerned, we do not just have that much confidence. So how that confidence can be brought? Only way is that for that you people have to speak only. So I know that you know everything. So these are so simple things that I'm single or I'm married and I'm divorced for saying. But in the flow of communication, you people are not able to use such words. So for that, I have told you that you people need to bring your passive vocabulary into active. Then you'll get number of choices of words, and you people can just spread or expect that your scope of expression will be broadened. Right now, if you're just trying to speak, you may get difficulties, lots of difficulties. But if you're practicing, these difficulties will be reduced. But see, if you're not doing anything and if you're just attending lectures, it doesn't mean that your English communication will be improved as far as oral communication. For that, you start speaking. If you're not speaking with your friends, at least you try to speak to yourself in loud voice, or better, I will suggest that you can stand in front of mirror and you people just try to speak in loud voice. Okay. Let's go now to the next slide, where you people can use some phrases asking for clarification. So asking for clarification means that you are just listening to someone, and in that case, what happened? You did not get what that person has said, or you did not listen properly and you do not understand what that person has said. So in that case, how you can ask for clarification? So these five phrases will help us to ask for clarification. So you might come across with the phrase of this pardon. So if somebody is saying pardon, it means actually sorry. So you might be using sorry. So suppose that somebody is telling you something and you didn't listen it or you didn't understand it. In that case, normally people say sorry. So when they say sorry, it means that that person has to explain it again. But pardon, it means that it is a polite and formal way to ask someone to repeat what they have said. So pardon, if you didn't hear or understand what the person said, in that case, you can use this pardon. Okay. Next, you may ask like this. Would you mind repeating that? So if you're asking, would you mind repeating that? It means that you are just asking them to repeat whatever they have just said. Because of some reasons, you don't understand it or you did not listen it. But So it is a request actually. Would you mind repeating that? It is a request in the form of question. So you people can use this. Then next, what do you mean asking for more information? So suppose that if somebody is talking about a point and you have an idea about that point, but you don't know much about that topic. So in that case, you can ask, what do you mean? So if you are asking what do you mean, so then you are just getting more information about that topic. But see, if the same is used in a rising tone, again, it will have negative meaning. Sometimes you might listen sentence like this, what do you mean? If somebody is asking it is in rising tone, what do you mean? It means that it is used in negative sense also. And in negative sense, it means that whatever you have said, you shouldn't say. So in that case, sometimes you might just listen such a sentence. Might be that if you are just in movies or as TV show, you might listen that, what do you mean, which is used in negative way. Then next, you people can say that, I'm not sure I follow you. So when you say, I'm not sure I follow you, it does not mean physically I follow you, but it means that I don't understand. So whatever you're saying, whatever you're telling, I don't understand. So in that case, you can say, I'm not sure I follow you. Then next way you people can also make requests like this. Could you explain the point again? Could you explain the concept again? Could you explain the chapter again? Or anything that you don't understand, you people can use it after explain. You can say, could you explain? And afterwards, you just mention what should be explained again. Okay. So these were the ways that you people can just choose for asking for clarification. So now, if you people are speaker now, so you're talking something, you're giving a presentation, or you have some conference, or you are just conducting meeting. So in that case, you are speaker, and whatever you have spoken, you just wanted to check if the other person or the listener understands you. So how that can be asked? So here you people will get five ways that you people can use for checking whether the person understands it or does not understand. Okay. So let's see that you people can ask like, do you understand what I am saying? If you are just asking like this, it means that you are checking whether whatever you have said is understood by the person or not. So in that case, you can ask like this. Then next, such questions you may come across that, does that make sense? If anybody is asking you that, does that make sense? It means that he or she is asking you, do you understand it or not? Or you can ask, if you are in the role of speaker, in that case, you can ask your audience whether they understand or not. In that case, you may ask them, does that make a sense? So this is the way to check understanding. Then next, you may ask like, do you know what I mean? So if you're asking like this, it means that you are just wanted to know if the audience understood to you or not. In that case, you can ask like this. Or if anybody is asking you, do you know what I mean? In that case, if you understand, you can say, yes, I know. Or if you don't understand, in that case, no, I don't. So this way, you people can reply to such situations. Then next, you people can just say, are you with me so far? It means that whatever, maybe there is a long speech or talk of 1 hour, 2 hours. In that 1 hour talk, if the teacher is or any presenter is talking for more than 20 minutes, 30 minutes. So after that, he wanted to check the understanding of the audience. So in that case, he may ask that, are you with me so far? So for it means that whatever right now we people have completed, up to there, are you getting or are you clear? So in that case, you may ask like this also. And here is the last way that you may use that, is that clear? So teachers might use such words when they wanted to check the understanding of the students. So in between of their lecture, they ask you, is that clear? So this is one of the way to ask for clarification. Again, remember that as I told you that you people can use this point number 5 in negative way also. So if you are just using it in plain way, that is that clear, means that you wanted to just know whether that person has understood or not. But if somebody is asking it in a rising tone like this, is that clear? So in that case, it is often used after giving orders or expressing disapproval or another negative attitude. So in that case, such kind of expression will be used. Okay. Is it clear? Is it audible for everyone? Give me someone reply apart from regular students, someone new. So I may ask somebody. Roll number 7, Aishwarya. Is it audible?
Ha, sir.
Okay, fine. Good. Then let's go to the next, where we people can use 5 ways to ask for help. Okay, so sometimes we people come across that difficulties and problems that we are in, and there we want to get help from someone. So in that case, it is difficult to just ask for help, or we do not may find the proper words to asking for help. So these 5 ways will help you that you can use for asking for help. So in plain words, you may ask someone that I need a little help. Okay. So this way you people may ask someone to help you. Next, you can just ask someone, could you help me out? So it means also the same that you are asking for help. Could you help me out? It means that you wanted to get help from someone. Then the next way, could you give me a hand? So here now you have to remember, if you are asking for a hand, it is used or considered for physical task or physical help. Means, for example, you are just climbing stairs, and because of some reasons you are not able to climb, so in that you need some support or you need hand of someone to climb the that stairs. So in that case, you may ask that, could you give me a hand? So it is actually used for physical help. Then next, you may ask that, could you spare a couple minutes? Or you can say, could you spare a couple of minutes? So if you're asking to spare a couple of minutes, it means that actually you wanted to take the time of that person. So he might be busy in his work, or he might be working on higher posts. And if you wanted to get some from, get help from these people, in that case, you can ask like that, could you spare a couple of minutes? And this is the last one that you may ask, could you do me a favor? So if it is a favor it means help. So if you are asking for help, you can use the word like this, could you give me a favor? Or could you do me a favor? So if somebody is doing a favor to you, it means that they are helping you. So these are the ways that you people can just use for asking for help. Again, remember that these are the phrases, just an example. You people can modify these examples. You people can search it on Google or you people can make your own examples, but you should bring variety, different kinds of words and vocabulary into communication. So this way, we people can improve. Okay, then let's go to the next slide. Here, you people can ask someone else to do something. So suppose that you are at a public place or somewhere and you wanted to tell someone to do something. So in that case, how you can just ask by using these examples? Let's see. That you're sitting in a room and you wanted to just get open the window. So there are some other people in that room and there is someone who is near the window and you're going to ask that person who is near the window. In that case, you may ask that person like this. Would you mind opening the window? So would you mind will be common. And this is just an example opening the window. So people can just replace this opening the window with other examples like that. Would you mind closing the door? Would you mind passing the salt? Would you mind closing the book? Would you mind rubbing the board? Or any other things that you people can just think that you are going to ask to do someone and the people can use it. Then next way, you can ask that, could you please? Again, remember all these ways are polite ways. And if you are just starting with could you please, it becomes a request. And then you people can say, could you please turn off the lights? So just an example, turn off the lights. There afterwards, you people can just use that. Could you please switch off the fan? Could you please turn on the TV? Could you please give me a book? Or could you please, and afterwards you just say what you wanted to do that person and just complete the sentence. Next, you people can also say that, can you? So what is the difference between could you and can you? So if you're using could you, it will be formal and polite. And if you're using can you, it will be not formal and it will be impolite also. Or you people have to use can with your friends, with your family members, or in informal situations. In that case, you people can use can. But if you're just using can to your colleague or to your boss, then it will be rude, arrogant to say can you please. So don't say can. There you people have to use could. So try to know the difference between can and could. I think that when we talked about modal auxiliaries, so that time you people have just discussed about that, how we can make requests by using can and could. So people just try to change, pass me the chicken. Instead of that, if people can just see that, again, similar examples like close the window, bring the glass of water, bring me a cup of tea. Likewise, the people may ask. Then again, the common and simple word that is using please. So people can just use please, and afterwards you can just put your sentence. Please send me the information. Please complete the task. Please write the report. Please do this. Please do that. So please is the word which makes your conversation more polite. In that case, the people may use this please, and then afterwards what you wanted to say. Then next, you people can just see, you people can so that I would appreciate it if you could. So if you are using this, it means that you are an elder person, or you are just having authority, or you are working on higher posts. In that case, you people can just say, I would appreciate it if you could. And then you just use the example. You can just replace this, wash the dishes. with your examples like this. I appreciate it if you could complete the work. I appreciate it if you could just finish the project or any other something that you wanted to do. So in that case, you can just use such type of sentence patterns, structures, and phrases. Okay, so here now we have next slide. So that we wanted to know, it is about 5 ways to interrupt someone. Okay, so let's see. Meanwhile, I'll check someone where they are attentive. So roll number 17, Venkatesh. Is it audible? Are you getting it, Venkatesh? Okay. Fine. So let's see. Many of the times what happens that people are talking, and in between we wanted to say something which might be important or which might be just you feel that you should start your conversation in between. So that time, how you can just interrupt someone. So here you people will get this 5 ways that you people can use for interrupting someone. And then you people can start like this. Sorry to interrupt, but, and then after but there is dot dot dot. So you can say that, sorry to interrupt, but I wanted to tell you that what information you have provided is not correct. So any other, I'm just giving an example here. Oh, sorry to interrupt, but it is time to leave now. So we have to go home. So this way also you people can use it. Then next way, that is again common, you may say like this: excuse me, could I talk to you for a minute? Or you can just ask like this: excuse me, do you have a minute? So in that case, what actually that people actually they he is busy with someone else while talking, and you wanted to just talk to that person. So in that case, you can ask like this: excuse me, could I talk to you for a minute? Or excuse me, do you have a minute? So here in bracket, you'll find that note is mentioned that when interrupting a conversation between two other people. So it means that already these two people, they are talking, and you're the third person who are going to interrupt them. So in that case, you people can use the words like this. Then next way, could I jump in here? So if somebody is saying that, could I jump in here? So what meaning of jump, we know it is totally different that in which context it is used here. So we know that jumping is just jumping on the floor, that we know. But here if you are saying, could I jump in here, it means that you are just interrupting a discussion among many people which is going on. So already you see that maybe meeting is going on, or already people they are discussing something, and you are the new one who are just going to join them, or you wanted to suggest to someone something, or you wanted to talk to someone from that group. So in that case, you can ask these people like this: could I jump in here? So this is the way that you people can use. Then next, you people can say, sorry, I just want to say that. If they're talking, you people can just apologize for interrupting them by saying sorry, and then you just tell them why you have interrupted them. You can say that, I just want to say that, and then you have to present the information that you are going to tell, or you that you are about to start. Okay, and here is the last one that you people can use. It is used in a formal situation. So people can say that, I have a word. So, may I have a word? So if you're saying, may I have a word, it means that you're asking permission to tell something that you know. Okay, so that was all about today. We will stop here. You people have to rejoin for quiz. Next time, we people will have the next phrase. Or in other situations, we will take more examples. and then we people will just continue. So meanwhile, again, those who did not attempt the test, these people can attempt the test again. Or if you wanted to improve your score, if you think that your score is less,